Hi, I'm Antonio Centeno. I'm the founder of Real Men Real Style. Today, I'm going to be giving you a guide to men's swimwear. All right, this is in support of my article over at The Art of Manliness, so make sure to go check out that article. In this video, I'm going to go over a little bit of the history of how did we come up with, you know, the certain types of swimwear that you see out there. Then I'm going to get into the types. So I'm going to go over trunks, board shorts, etc., etc. Then I'm going to be giving you three tips on how to make a smart purchasing decision. Now, we're already in the summer, so I know many of you guys are you have a need for some good trunks. Maybe you've got to go to a company picnic, or you just want to go to the beach. And we're going to talk about the different types of swimwear that you should be thinking about. Okay, so let's go ahead and get into it. The history of men's swimwear, where for a long time, there really wasn't any men's swimwear. And for most of recorded history, men actually just swam naked. We would just go jump the river, go jump in the ocean. We didn't have pools, and it was something that, you simply would just jump in, strip down and just go in. And then in the 19th and 20th century, things changed. There were a lot of restrictions that were put on human nudity. In fact, anytime missionaries or people from, let's just say, mostly Western Europe, other parts of maybe North America, they would go, let's say, to Hawaii or Polynesia, they would see people still, you know, swimming and bathing naked. They would say, you know, that's a whole nother story. But let's just say in 1934, there was a movie, and it was called It Happened One Night. Clark Gable, he really, you know, caused a stir because he took off his shirt and he didn't have an undershirt on. So in 1935 in Atlantic City, we saw 42 men over the period of a year who were actually ticketed because they were bare-chested on the beach. Yes, at this time period, right before World War II, you could not be bare-chested out swimming or in public. It was considered indecent. And then in 1936, things started to change. New York, I think it was Westminster, was the first city that actually said, okay, we're just going to allow it. And then for economic reasons, especially, you know, as the war came up and all of a sudden we had shortages of clothing, and afterwards, all of a sudden, it was the floodgates opened. In the 1960s, we saw a whole lot of swimsuits. That's when wetsuits came about. All types of swimsuits came out. And so that leads me to the types. Now, for most men, and I'll talk about this in buying as well, trunks are going to be perfectly fine. There's a whole lot of other styles out there, but trunks, for the vast majority of men throughout the world, are going to be perfectly fine. Now, over in Europe, I know you guys are seeing a lot. There's a lot more of people wearing Speedos. I remember going to the beaches down in down in Yalta in the Crimea area. This was before the Russian takeover. But when I was there, you saw guys walking around in Speedos all the time. Same thing in Croatia when I was over there, and Italy. I believe you're going to see about the same thing as well. So a lot more Speedos over. So again, everything here we're talking is more North American faced, but I will talk about Speedos. So trunks. Number one, I think, is going to be the most common, the most default, the one that you can default to, and you're pretty much not going to be wrong in most situations. Now, from trunks, we have seen board shorts evolve, and board shorts have really become a lot more fashionable, especially in the last probably five to seven years. I've seen board shorts everywhere, and in fact, many of you guys go out and you're looking to buy a pair of swim shorts, and all they have are board shorts, and that's what you end up purchasing. Now, I'll get into this at the very end about why board shorts aren't maybe the best decision for many men out there, but we've got trunks, board shorts, then we start to get into what are known as swim briefs / Speedos. Now, you've seen these, and many of you guys, I know you're snickering. It's like, oh, you know, I would never be caught in that. But actually, if you're a professional or if you're a competitive swimmer, if you're the kind of guy that jumps in and you don't want, in a sense, basically your legs, the material to chafe, then this is a pretty good and very functional piece. It does the job. Most actually swim briefs are double lined. So there's not a whole lot of, I mean, you definitely can tell what you got there. But again, you know, it's just in the last couple of hundred years that we've had this complex with, I guess, the human body. But also with that, we also see thongs as well. Now, thongs are actually a traditional piece, especially over in Japan, and thongs were something that was considered perfectly fine. Now, they do expose the difference between thongs and briefs is that they actually show more of the buttocks. Now, let's get into square cut. This actually had a very strong time period. I think if you go look at Daniel Craig in one of the James Bond movies, he's actually wearing a square cut as well, but it has been around for a long time. Long term. And if you've got a good build, if you've actually, you're a taller man with a good build, I think square cut is actually a great cut for you. Now, jammers. Jammers, my son wears jammers. He actually used to swim for the local swim team. Now, jammers are going to be for those of you that want to be a bit more competitive. At the same time, you're not looking to wear briefs and you want to be a little bit more modest. And at the same time, you want something that's very functional. Basically, they look like spandex fit over, but they are different. Usually jammers are going to be made from a material which can deal, and we'll talk about this when making a smart purchasing decision, but jammers are usually made from material that's a bit stronger and can deal with some of the harsh chemicals in pools. Now, racing suits. This is what you're going to see for those of guys out there that are competitive. So look at the guys at the Olympics. Racing suit is all about being aerodynamic in the water. A lot of swimmers, and if anyone's ever swam, it's one of those things right before the meet. You remember how you shave everything? You shave your arms, shave your legs. And I mean, I've heard of guys, you know, shaving their eyebrows. You know, it's crazy. But the idea is you want that very smooth feel when you hit the water and you feel like you shoot right through. And there are some swimmers that'll say, you know, by shaving all the hair off their body, they take a little bit of time right off of their race. So who knows? Okay. So wetsuits, rash guards, swim shirts, those things, and I'm not wearing a swim shirt here, I just happen to touch my chest, but those evolved and those are usually associated with, in a sense, performance enhancing. So the rash guards, obviously they're protecting you from rash, maybe from if you're light colored skin and you don't want to get, or if you're dark colored skin, but you're out in the sun quite a bit and you don't want to get sunburned. Wetsuits. If you're going to be surfing in California and that water can get pretty darn cold, then you can wear a wetsuit, get out there, and you'll be perfectly fine for a longer period of time. You're not going to suffer hypothermia. So quite a wide variety of types out there. And so how do you make a good purchasing decision? How do you buy the perfect pair of swimsuits for you? Okay, so number one is think about your needs. Obviously, if you need a wetsuit, you know you need a wetsuit. You're not going to go with a pair of briefs. It's just, but many of you guys are out there saying, okay, you know, I'm looking at all these different styles. What should I go with? By default, think trunks. For the vast majority of you guys, their trunks can be worn with a button-up shirt, like this shirt right here. I could wear with a pair of swim trunks at a pool party and be pretty good. You know, it's not going to be the most fashionable look, but it's going to work for, you know, for most cases. So if you're going to be competitive swimming, if you're a triathlete, then you want to look at something that's going to, in a sense, make you feel better. Possibly, you know, most of those guys are wearing that one piece, then that's what you want to look at. If you're going to be swimming in the pool in the mornings, then hey, there's nothing wrong with going with a pair of Speedos or going with a pair of jammers so that you actually can focus on, well, what needs to happen, which is you swim in those laps, not you having to retie or stop in the middle of your warm-up swim to tie up your trunks. Okay, so we've talked about your need. Figure out what your need is. Go with that first off. Then think about the visual impression. Okay, so some of you guys maybe have company picnics coming up. In that case, do not go. You have to be pretty culturally sound. So let's say that you're French or you're German, you're visiting a client over in the United States, you get invited to a pool party. This doesn't mean that you want to pull out those Speedos. I know they're perfectly fine in the beaches over there, let's say in southern France, but in the United States, you're going to basically, they're going to give you the, I mean, no one's going to say anything. They're just going to say, oh, he's German or he's European. But it is going to be definitely something that's going to be a topic. And I don't think it's the topic that you want to bring up at a company picnic party or something like that. And the same being, don't show up in a wetsuit or don't show up in a competitive swimsuit if you're just going to the lake in Wisconsin. I mean, trunks, again, are going to be default for most of you guys. However, if you've got a good build, then don't be afraid to pull out the board shorts. And that's what I was, you know, the last point that you need to pay attention to is your body type. And this is where if you're a tall, well, you know, decent shape guy, maybe you've got a little bit of a midsection, but it's not bad. You could actually wear the square shorts. Now, when it comes to board shorts, they're not going to hide it, but they're also not going to exaggerate it. And that's what you're looking for. There's really not much you can do about your midsection unless you go like to a really old school bathing suit. But guys, again, trunks de facto, and depending on your needs, what visual message you want to send, and the body type, that's what you're going to determine. Now, some of you guys, and it's going to be hard to make a purchasing decision if you just go into Old Navy or you go into Target. There aren't many options out there. That's the beautiful thing. We can shop online. So actually go and look at Speedo is a great, you know, they have a great selection right there. Now, a lot of brands, and a lot of times you're wondering, okay, what am I paying for? Because I'm looking at, you know, I go to one website and I see a Dolphin brand or I see Speedo. It looks like the same thing, but this one's $20 cheaper. Why would I pay $50 for a suit here versus $20 or $25 for what looks to be the same suit here? So be careful. Sometimes you're going to pay for just the name. But other times what you're paying for is actually a little bit higher quality build. Usually there's two factors in that. There is the quality of the material that's being used. So it actually is going to look better. It's going to feel softer. I actually have a pretty inexpensive pair of swim trunks and a nicer pair. And what I noticed immediately after about 10 to 15 wears and washes is that the least expensive pair, it actually got a lot rougher and it started to fade as well. So that's a nice thing about a nicer suit, especially if you're going to the pool every single day, is that it's going to maintain a nicer feel and it's usually not going to fade as quickly. Now, after a year, even the best suits, if you're wearing them 5 days a week to the pool, they're going to fall apart. Just understand that that's just the cost. I mean, and when you're buying a suit, look at it, okay, what kind of impression do I want to send? Other quick things also on the fit is, and I get more into this in the article, but I talk also about the inseam and the length of how far they go down your leg as well. But hopefully after this video, guys, you have a better understanding of menswear. And remember, when you're out there making a purchasing decision, think about your need, then think about what message you want to send, and then think about what's going to suit your body best. All right, guys, if you want more information about men's style, you know I've got that free 47-page ebook on men's style over at realmenrealstyle.com. Go grab it, become a better dressed man, and that's it, guys. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.